So on the one hand, we find God has come. God has created us in His image, in His goodness. And we read in the book of Genesis chapter 1, verse 28, God said, be blessed. You carry my breath, my blessing. So, the carrying my blessing means what? Wherever you go, you will be multiplying. You will be filling this earth. And if anybody comes against you, with my power, you will subdue the nation. Yes. On the one hand, man carries the power and presence of God. With the power and presence of God, he can multiply. He can fill this earth. He can subdue the nations. He can subdue and destroy every power of darkness. On the other hand, the darkness comes with its power to blind the human mind, to disturb the human mind, to play with the human persons, to fill the man with the fear, worries, anger, discouragement, disappointment. That's why we read in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, know who are you? God has not created you with a spirit of fear. If fear, worries, sickness, discouragement, and all kinds of things are found in you, remember, God has not given you the spirit of fear, but He has given us the spirit of power, spirit of love, spirit of self-discipline. Yes, that's why we read in the book of Isaiah chapter 9 verse 2, you can read, though God has created us in His goodness and love, the enemy is trying to bind man with all his sickness, with all his tricks. Now we read the book of Isaiah chapter 9 verse 2.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light.
Though man who is called to live, called to possess eternal, knowingly, unknowingly, he has fallen into the trap of the enemy. But God did not leave him. He sees his children who are supposed to live in life are walking in darkness. So he made an arrangement. He did something. What did he do? Something whereby those who are walking in darkness can see a great light. This is the good news. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord said in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 7, verse 8, will the people who are fallen, should they lie down where they are fallen? No! They should get up and leave my children. That's why in Isaiah 9:2 he says, those who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Hallelujah.
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 The people who are walking in darkness have seen a great light. Yes.
Those who lived in a land of deep darkness.
And those who are knowingly, unknowingly, they are living in the deep darkness of sickness. People have said, this is the end of your life. You are dying with the cancer. People have said, your husband doesn't believe in you. Your wife doesn't love you. And your family is broken. People are saying, knowingly, unknowingly, you have thrown yourself into all kinds of debts. And you cannot come out of your debts. People who are living in deep darkness. Your husband has fallen into the trap of habit of drinking alcohol. And his body is full of sickness. His liver is gone. His intestine is gone. His stomach is gone. His digestive system is gone. People may say, you are those who walk in deep darkness. A good news has come. That those who walk in the deep darkness, they have seen a great light. God Himself sends His Son for us. Those who walk in deep darkness have seen a great light. A great hope for them. Yes?
On them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy.
So those who are living in darkness, they have seen light. Those who are tied up, they have seen a great joy. Great power began to operate in them once again. They thought they are dying. Now a great power begins to operate in them. They once again begin to multiply. They begin to see the joy of God in their lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So in Telugu, it is written like that. Andhakara Rajyamlo Unavariki. Tamilam Pashamlo, Irul Achila Irupavarilke, Pudhiya Velicham Kadaitade. So those who are in the kingdom of darkness, are you? Is your family? Is your body is being tied up or being ruled by the darkness? Don't lose courage. A new hope has come through the person of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's why we read in the book of Hebrews, chapter 2, verse 15. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 2, verse 15, it is written like this. Those who are held up in slavery, many people are held up in the slavery of their evil spirit. See, slavery of evil habits, slavery of caught up in wrong relationship, slavery of some kind of sickness, slavery of debt problems. So those who are caught up in the slavery and they were led to the death, their slavery leads them into death, yes? By the fear of death.
For it is clear that he did not come to help angels, but the descendants of Abraham.
Those who are living in the death, they are in order to give their life, Jesus Christ, he came with the flesh and blood and to free those who were through fear of death. He had been subject to slavery. People are living in slavery. To free them, Jesus says, the Son of God said, I will become slavery. I will enter into slavery. I will lose my heavenly glory. I will leave. The angels are praising me. I will leave. And I will become a man. I will become a slave. I am ready to do anything for my children. Why? He will taste death. He will subject himself to slavery. That surely he did not help the angels, but rather the descendants of Abraham, the children of God. Therefore, he had to become like his brothers. The children of God, what are the suffering that they're going through? Because of their sin, what are the sickness they are going through? What are the pain they are going through? So he has taken the flesh like you and me. He went through hunger. He went through pain. He went through being neglected. He went through the experience of people who trusted in him. They went against him. They left him. He experienced loneliness. Today, are you going through all that? In order to tell you, as we read in Hebrews 2:18, because he went through all that, today he is able to tell you, my son, what you go through, I have gone through. My daughter, your suffering, I know it. Your temptation, I know it. How you are being destroyed, I know it. Because he has gone through, he is able to understand us and tell us, I know your pain. I know you. You are not alone. Hallelujah.